Dan, you should know that's when I was tall. Been here 36 years, and they whittle you down when you're here. But first of all, let me thank you for being here. Your great work with the NBA, the entertainment they provide. My first question is, what are we going to do about the Knicks? How do we get them back on track? You've got to start winning for us here. But in all seriousness, for some of us here, this question about legal sports betting is not only a question of if we should do it, but doing it right if we do it. And for some of us, like myself, who represents the 49th Senatorial District, one of the largest districts in the state, 4,000 square miles, bigger than Rhode Island and Delaware. But part of it is Schenectady, part of it is Saratoga. I go into rural areas in Hamilton, Herkimer County, and Fulton County. But you should know that the second most famous person in the city of Schenectady is Thomas Edison. He developed a light bulb, helped develop General Electric. The first most famous person is Pat Riley. You may know him. We named the gym after him in Schenectady, and he comes back and visits every once in a while. Had the opportunity to work with him in some sports programs and clinics. Our concern is we have venues in areas in some of our districts, other sporting venues. We just opened a Rivers Casino in the city of Schenectady. We have one of the most beautiful, I hope you've been there, I invite you to come there, beautiful racetracks, not only in New York, not only in this nation, but in the world, Saratoga Thoroughbred Racetrack. We have a racino in harness racing out there in Saratoga. So we're especially concerned on how they're going to fit in to this whole process, probably, because that's going to be a question if we open up sports betting, because you've heard the term saturation, and you know, we want to keep the venues alive that we have. And this is an economic issue as well as an entertainment issue for individuals. But the question I have relates to one of the points you made here about if we do this, I'm going through your points, some of the betting might be more manipulative than other types of betting. Can you just give me one example of what that concern would be for the NBA in terms of being more manipulative of a betting type of opportunity as it relates to the NBA? You know, when I played, if they bet I'd get more assists than shots, they'd lose a lot of money because, you know, I like to shoot. And I know that I like to shoot in the NBA, but they play some good defense too. But what would be a more manipulative type of betting?
Sure. Well, I'll give one example from overseas and then talk about the NBA. So one bet that got some attention in the last year or so was a bet on whether a particular player in a European Football League would eat a sandwich at a certain point in the game. Obviously it has no bearing on the actual outcome of the game, the score or anything like that, but it got a bunch of attention. He did it. And then there were disciplinary proceedings and investigations and things like that that ensued. I know it seems just sort of like a silly example, but the fact is, like, this actually created integrity issues by having this bet type that was something that was just completely separated from and easy to manipulate relative to the game. In our sport, and I think, you know, this could be said for any sport, the concern is higher with bets that involve individual players and where poor performance or acting in a way that is separate from your overall performance in the game is going to determine the outcome of a bet. So one example I gave is whether a player is going to commit the first foul of the game, which is something that wouldn't affect necessarily how the game turns out, wouldn't necessarily make a player look like they were not playing as hard as they could in the game. And something that might be more open to manipulation. I'm not saying necessarily that's something that should just flat out not be allowed. There are other ways you can deal with that. Maybe it's the bet amount is lower on certain bets like that, or there are other protections that need to be put in place. But those are the types of things I think that all leagues would need to look at when the betting market opens and also becomes more sophisticated over time. It's not just going to be over-unders. It's not just going to be point spread, but you're going to have a lot of other in-game proposition type bets.
You have the potential of getting some deep water with that type of thing, because the first three-point shot, the first technical foul, you could get into a lot of areas where those would be suggested as being manipulative bets. And I guess there's a potential there, if you talk about that, that that may become illegal, some of those types of things, in terms of, you know, it's illegal to bet on sports right now, except for Las Vegas. So there's still going to be a venue for some of that illegality in the areas you're talking about.
I'm glad you raised that, because one thing that we're sensitive to and how we're thinking about this is wanting to make sure that that legal operators can compete with the illegal operators. And so you don't want to be unnecessarily and overly restricting what operators can do. If these bets are going to be available on illegal markets and popular there, then maybe there's a case to be made for trying to do it the right way in a legal market. So I think what I'd want to be taken away from this is, I don't have a list of particular bets today that I would say these should just flat out not be allowed. I think it's an area, though, where there's more scrutiny that should be put on them, and league should have a say in how it turns out.
Thank you.